The district's chief administrative officer, Moses Kanyarutoche, and the principal human resources officer, Celestino Kawesa, made the revelations while appearing before the Public Accounts Committee in charge of local government, chaired by Clark South legislator Gilbert Olanya.
20 secondary school teachers, those who are not supposed to be paid, they accessed our payroll illegally. As a result, government lost about 160 million.
The committee was interrogating audit queries raised by the Auditor General's report for the 2021-2022 financial year.
You are not acting, you are not stopping them. They continue to get money from government for 7 years on the payroll. Accounting officer explained to the committee why that happened so.
Cases of forgery were deleted from the payroll, and the matter was referred to Ministry of Education and Sports and Police.
The Auditor General highlighted that 160.39 million shillings was paid to 20 secondary schools and tertiary employees who had been fraudulently put on the payroll. To conceal their dark side, the suspects even taught at schools where they were purportedly posted before vanishing.
Human resource, give us evidence. After deleting, did you recover that money?
Honorable Chairperson.
Yes, continue.
These people had forged appointment letters, went in and verified. These people went on run. However, we wrote to police, and police has started investigations.
By next financial year, if the same queries appears, then we may be forced to recommend that the money should be recovered from you as you look for those people so that they pay the money. Right now, government lost about 160 million, and you are saying all those people disappeared. That one cannot happen.
Since then, Kanyarutoche told MPs that the fake teachers have been scrapped off the payroll, but efforts to recover these public funds are still futile. In such instances, Kawesa explained that money can only be recovered from civil servants who are still on the payroll.
I wish to inform you that these people were on payroll and they were teaching in those respective schools. They were there teaching, and even the head teachers have made statements.
And yet he's now referring us to police. Much as he has given us those letters, he should be able also to give us the reference police file numbers, because we cannot now start inquiring minus those file numbers. Not everything that for you will be here, we first tell you that we are going for further investigations from police.
However, members of PAC were not convinced that money is not recoverable, wondering why none of the suspects have been arrested.
How much have you recovered so far from those who have not run away? We want to know the current status.
The accounting officer and the team, they are under obligations to have these people arrested.
Deducting from the report, the aforementioned suspects, whose names remain concealed to avoid jeopardizing investigations, illegally accessed the payroll and were only to be detected in the 2021-2022 financial year. Report compiled by Fred Kajubi for the news.